Okay, so here is a video on how to take it apart. Now you just gotta take the screws out, which are on the other side. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws, big screws, and 2 little ones right there. I've lost mine because they're really little. So you gotta be careful with these. The Nintendo gun will still work if you don't have those. It's just that you can pull this apart. Okay, so now I've got all the screws out. It's these, and I already told you I'm missing these 2 screws. So you take off the gray part right here, and then you pick up the gun like that, and you'll have an extra screw right there. Now I'm gonna unscrew it. It's kind of hard holding the camera and unscrewing it at the same time. That's why I need a camera stand. And don't worry about getting your screws all messed up in combination, because they're all the same size. Okay, now you take the top off. It's very easy. Sometimes it's very hard if it's new, but I'm sure none of them are new. Because back in 1985. So you can spray paint that. It is allowable because there's nothing. No whatever chips in there, so you can spray paint that now. But I would go ahead and take out this stuff right here. Now this battery, you gotta remember each side to put it in there. It's some kind of battery, so you just gotta remember, like, shape it out like that. It's okay if you get the sponge wet or spray painted. It's okay, you just gotta let it dry out. And right here it will have tape around it. See, I put new tape around it because the other stuff just kept sticking to it. So these are 2 metal things. It's okay to touch. It don't matter which way you put it like that. It's okay. Now you just put it set aside right there. And then you got a little difficult part right here. So you got a screw right here. Kind of hard to take out. Don't worry, it's the same size. Let's put it with the group. No, don't stick. This screwdriver is a magnet. Okay, let's see. Now I think that's all. Now there's 3 more. Okay, they'll be done in just a second. Okay, now I've taken out the screws. You've got the sponge. Here's the lens right here. Mine was laying right there for some reason. It stays right there. It don't matter which side, as long as it's clean. And just kind of make sure you don't touch the part right there. If you do, just like get a little bit of Windex and then clean it, because you have to have this in order to shoot the gun, I think. So just set that aside. And just set this out. And set this out right here. And you pretty much got that. So you gotta unwire this and loosen these. Make sure you remember how you curve them. Or you can watch the video back. See? And then there you go. There's the other side. You can spray paint that. Spray paint both of those. Spray paint both of these. Okay, now we're going to be putting it back together. Okay, make sure you have these screws and 2 little screws. 2 little screws. The lens, the little round thing, the battery, the cord shape. Make sure it's shaped like that. And make sure that wire is not cut, or your Nintendo is screwed. Well, your Nintendo gun. I ain't never really figured out what that is. It looks like you plug it up in the wall. or something. I don't even know if it's supposed to be sticking out, but it still works. Okay, and that's how you take it apart. Now we're about to put it back together. Okay, so I'm going to make sure you still had the same size as the battery. It don't matter which way it's been rolled, because that would have been way too difficult. Get this, put it on the sponge, make sure it's straightened out, make sure the sides aren't sticking out like that. And make sure if you don't have tape around it, make sure you put tape around it, because that'll help it. Okay, now we're moving on to the lens. Don't really matter which side you put it on, as long as you put it right there. Right there. It may be a little loose, like you can just flick it off. Sometimes not, though. Okay, so this is the most important part of the gun, right here. So you need to put that over like that and get this part and put it. See, this is kind of hard to put back in the gun. See, there's this little clip right there where you can lay the chip right there and kind of push it down. All right, now here's a little difficult part. Here's the wires. You push them down in there. Hold on. Push him down. Gotta push him down. Alright, hold on. Okay, so now I've got the wires in. Just make sure you wrap it around that circle. Make sure they're kind of sticking in. It's okay if they stick out just a little bit. Pull it all the way down. Battery's right there. Make sure you wrap it around the top. On the bottom to the left. Over on the left one, curved under to the right, and over this one, curved down to down. Now, that black thing's not supposed to be right there, but I keep it right there because it makes my cord kind of stay there better, because I really can't pull this out further out here, but that's just if you want to make your cord just a teeny bit longer, but I think that's kind of weird. So anyway, you got this lined up through that, you got your lens on it, you have this, make sure it's got that, and you need to put the screws back in these three holes, which I'm about to do, and make sure your wire doesn't is connected. Okay, and I'm putting the screws in. Okay, now I have the three screws in, it don't matter which screws, like I told you. These are a little hard to push in, so it's okay if they just kind of loosen a little bit. Well, that's only for my gun, but I'm sure it is for other guns because they're old freaking screws. Okay, now, flip that over. Lay the gun over it. Come on, move that out of the way. Lay the gun over it. Match the holes. Holding the camera. I see that right there with the lens. Every time I do that, the lens just falls out. Okay, now they're in, and that's where the screws go from this part right here. And now, if you did spray paint this, once it's dry, you just put it over. Now, hold on. I'm not sure about taking that apart, but you can if you like, but as once again, it's not my fault that if you break your Nintendo gun, and put that over, and you just put the rest of the screws back in the holes, and don't forget about the little ones. Which I don't have mine in, but if you don't want to forget about them, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. This is Wazam939, and thank you for watching a video of taking apart your 1985 Nintendo Zapper. Bye.